this is about bringing Kek to life again. This is the first step. In not making Kek someone that I control, but respecting that Kek is, in fact, in control of what we have happening in this world. Kek, as an example of the premortal darkness, he must be shown that respect by making him as dark as the darkest night.
darkness the chaos will bring. You, my Lord, I, your Master, we are one and the same. We are in union with each other. Oh great Kek, who from the very foundation is, was, and always will be. I bow before you. I ask for this, my Lord. This is our request for the House of Helel. Deep, abiding respect that we, as the House of Helel, have for you. For this is your age. This is our age. The age of darkness, of discontentment. The age of chaos. So be it that our will be done, that you cast in our enemies the darkness in their mind, so that they may not see us, so that they may be confused and not know where we are, and not be able to defeat us, nor stamp out that light. This is our will. Our will be done. Shem HaForash. Or Sunu Vergahi Goha. I reign over you, saith the dragon eagle of the primordial chaos. Verina, Vabraza, De Tohim, Vadmana. I am the first and the highest that live in the first ether. I am the terror of the earth, the horns of death, pouring down the fires of life on the earth. Zev Eli Aidia Deis Rav Ilaya Zaro Kayafi Kosago Posapela Deloch Penpira Mel Perge Keo Seage Zazas Zazas Nasat Tanata Zazas. Thank you. first eon, I was the great spirit. In the second eon, men knew me as the horned god. Pagenta, Panphage. In the third eon, I was the dark one, the devil. In the fourth eon, men knew me not, for I am the hidden one. In the new eon, I appear before you as Baphomet, God before all gods, Shalador. Ilasa, Tavanu, Laeb, Herta, Casamana Ru, Upa, Ahis, Dara. Sarris, Zoraka, Odo, Zoramartu, Odo, Sikali, Wa, Zorarji, Lapa, Soriario, Mana, Asahaji, Satan. O thou, the governor of the first plane, under whose wings are the spinners of cobwebs that weave the earth with dryness, and knowest the great name. Righteousness. In the seal of the false honor, move therefore and appear. Open the mysteries of your creation. Be friendly unto me. I am the same, a true worshiper of the highest. As the darkest day, begins as winter begins, so I, trusting in you, Lord of Darkness, open forth your eye so that you might see and know who it is that serves you, as you protect us, your great and glorious Father of Darkness. May this open up your eye so that you might see and you might know who is in true harmony with you. My ally Kek, you have been brought forth by those who do not know nor care to know you. They have forsaken you. And I, in the House of Helel, have opened your eyes so that you might see that you will stand in vigilant guard of the one true faith, the one true understanding. This is my will. I would like to take this time to speak to those who still are holding on hope for this man that you have been supporting all this time, the man who will soon be president. His interests are not yours. There is no reason for me to tell you this. There's no reason to put myself out there for ridicule, which I know I will receive. I'm here to tell you that all your efforts in bringing forth this ancient primordial God has not reaped anything for you. I am and have been for quite some time heavily involved in occult practice. Whether or not you want to believe it, this is the same thing that you have done. You have already committed yourself to occult practice by engaging in this, what you call, meaning magic. It is chaos magic. I, in this form, embody the true chaos. There is no god of chaos. There is no god of chaos. Kek is a primordial god of darkness. What you were looking for doesn't make any sense, because what you're doing is you're trying to establish this beacon of light that you believe, this white knight in the form of the man who will soon be president. But you're doing it through a dark lord. In the months and days ahead, initially, you're going to see great things occur in this country and in this world. This man who you have worked so hard for will start to display things that at first will seem as though he's everything that you thought he was. He's not. He's not. His purpose is not to bring in the light. His purpose is to bring in the darkness. His purpose is to bring in the chaos, which is my purpose. You speak against what you call Luciferian elites. Yet what you're seeing before your very eyes is the chaos that comes before the order. Order of Chao. It is not too late for you, even for those who voted for this man. You must, in a manner of speaking, repent for your misdeeds. Speaking of repenting towards any Abrahamic God, I'm speaking of recognizing what you have done is wrong. Recognizing that to support him has given you nothing in return. I am here for you. I am here to listen to you. I am here to take your abuse, which I will, but mostly understand. If you truly want to be an agent of chaos, you must learn how to control it. This happened, the synchronicities that happened, that rose this god, this primordial god, out of the darkness. That was not your doing. You were simply instruments. Now, the question for you is, do I want to be more than an instrument? Do I want to learn how to work chaos instead of it working on me? That's really the question that you have to ask yourself, because you continue down this rabbit hole that you are going down. The only possible outcome will be madness. If, however, you want to learn how to swim with the tide, this is like an ocean. You can either learn how to ride the waves, or the waves will sink you. And there'll be nothing left. I truly, truly want to reach out to those who want to heal. If you have nasty comments, you're only a fool. You're only hurting yourself. What I am offering you is how to ride those waves. Because either you learn to ride them like a surfer riding a wave. The surfer does not control the wave. The surfer learns to ride the wave. This is what chaos is. You are trying to inflict your will upon the wave. You cannot do this. But what you can do is learn how to ride it. And I'm here to help anyone who wants to do this. If you show me proper respect, you want a leader that will actually speak to you, a leader who will actually know you, who will actually help you? Or do you want to continue to look towards a man who has nothing for you except whatever feeds his own narcissistic megalomania? It's your choice. This is what this is about. We are the light. I am the chaos. My wife, she is the order. I am the darkness that comes before the light. If you want to know how to endure for the next several months and years, contact me. Join our home, for you are welcome here.